and I'm not born like a terrorist. Sometimes there is a good cause in war, even there is killing and all kinds of stuff. My future, I don't know. I'm here for the moment. Belgium cover news came yesterday, 2 weeks ago. There's still negotiation. They are scared. It's fully their right to be scared and to want to make a good plan before taking us. It's 1,000,000% right. But like I said, I didn't get arrested in a fight or something. I surrendered myself to the SDF and coalition force. For the first time, they opened the safe route to surrender. They promised us human rights, all that kind of stuff. Coalition and SDF, we are waiting for it. Our country gonna take us back, you know. The only thing I can say I really regret, not to come to Syria, of course, I came to help. I didn't left my mother, even like a teenager, till today my mother had this paper. I just write, I'm gonna go help the Syrian people against this asset, and I'm gonna come back. My mother till today had this paper, you know. So I came really young age, brainwashed. And I'm not born like a terrorist. Like in Belgium, we have some people, they are just normal. Study, work, have family. They have people become they become mafia, killing also, cocaine, drugs, also bad. They have people become terrorists. They have a lot of ways. What happened to me, I became a radical terrorist in the end. From practicing till extremist terrorist.
So I'm telling you that you were big in the food circle from a teenager, you became a radical and then you became de-radicalized. So now you don't believe it. Ideology.
Of course not. Of course
so
not.
What made you
dream? I told you, they promised us dreams, promised us stuff.
What dreams do they
like? You can live good, everything is okay, no corruption, etc., etc., etc. In the end, it was all corruption. And they killed their own people. We were going to example an American army go attack in the country, and while they're attacking, he's killing his own people for no reason.
So now do you regret coming to Syria?
Regret came to these terrorist groups and all this stuff, but the theoretically coming to Syria, no, I came to help. Every war is bad in the world? Of course not. When the Americans came to help the French against the Britons, my origin is Morocco. My grandfather fought with the French against Hitler. When they went for a good cause, you know. Sometimes there is a good cause in war, even there is killing and all kinds of stuff. But of course I regret this terrorist stuff and all this ISIS. So go back home. I know I'm gonna go to court and jail. I know this, pay the price. But like I say, in every religion, the word regret is not like I'm regret and that's it. Of course, I need to show I regret. I need to don't like this act, never do it again. And I'm ready to go finish my studies, work, show the community I'm good, till they say you can go back out.
So you want to go back and lead a normal life?
Yeah, of course. I have a wife, children. I came to Syria and I'm married.
Did you marry in Syria?
No, I married from Holland.
Did you get married after coming to Syria?
Yeah, married in Syria, a Holland woman. I have two children, Zakaria and Mohammed. Responsibility.
Where are they?
10 months, I don't know why. They tell us nothing. The day we surrender till today, nothing. We think in the camp, they say it is in the camp. I don't know exactly where now.
You
were
searching?
Yeah, of course. 10 months, I don't see them. Are they alive, dead?
When did you get jailed? Since when are you in this prison?
First I was in the hospital of Shaddad because I was very bad injured. Till today I'm injured, you know. Because when the last days in Babus, I'm diabetic because of this injury. I'm 5 years diabetic and I didn't have insulin in Babus, so I fell KO. So they put me in the hospital, give me again insulin. But like now there is no insulin again for 5 days. So if it stays, they promised to bring. But if they by mistake forget or something happen, I just die, you know.
So you wish you could get out, see your wife and children, take them back to Belgium?
Not even. I'm prepared to take my wife and children. I'm prepared to take my wife and children and go anywhere. To China, to the South Pole, North Pole, bring me to the desert, do what you want. Just take me somewhere out.
We have nothing
of news, what's happening. I'm not stupid, you know, I know when I was in Babus, there was war happening from all countries, up, down, left, right, I don't need to say names now. What they did, what they acted, I don't know. We who's close, who's far. This is our country of war. I don't think even international laws, war prisoners that surrender themselves and say they regret, even a lot of people don't believe to let them here, I don't know. You are inside, yeah, die here. I don't know, handed over to some crazy neighboring countries. I don't know, stuff like this. It's a big risk to stay here, I think.
What is a big risk? What is a big risk?
I go maybe to, I don't know where.
Sorry?
Neighboring countries, I told you. To bad neighboring countries.
Do you mean travel that distance here or?
Speaking, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. Like I told you, the most people here, they don't even need to regret because they are civilians, by example. They had a son, or they can run away from the Assad, and you have from Iraq, they run away from the Shias. And then in the end, ISIS proposes to run away to retreat to the desert of Syria and Iraq. And I refused, like a lot of people refused. And then they just left us in these villages.